Well, Bob, this weekend I went out to the farmer's market and I was a little chilly out there.
Oh, yeah.
But later on in the day, you know, those clouds kind of passed over and it was nice again. So
it was relaxing. Where it's jackets in the morning and shorts in the afternoon. That's the way it went.
Right.
I played golf, did the same thing.
Okay.
You know, I had layered clothing to start the morning off, tee time at 9, and then all of a sudden by, 2 o'clock in the afternoon, it was nice,
right,
sunny, and then
back to normal almost.
Yeah. A little bit above normal now. Viewer photos sent in. We had this nice shot near Venice. Appreciate that. Again, Susanna sending that one in, and this one coming from Michelle, who took this, and they were pleasantly surprised by the sunset tonight because clouds have been on again and off again, but mostly on again throughout most of the afternoon and evening. So we did see quite a bit of clouds, but the sunset, not too bad considering, and temperatures have been on the warm side. Now, as far as the rainfall goes, we have a low pressure area developing right here. It's actually developed already. It's going to drift very slowly to the southeast and fill up. What that means by filling up is that it's going to weaken and not be too much of a factor over the upcoming days in terms of any kind of heavy rain, but some moderate rain now working its way basically with the warm front, and you can see some heavier rain from the Keys stretching up toward Naples and then running into the coastline there of Sarasota and Manatee counties. So we can expect mainly coastal showers through the early hours and then maybe a few inland showers before sunrise as all this kind of works its way around the periphery of that low pressure system. Elsewhere across the U.S., a fast moving storm system brought some freezing rain to the looks like North Atlanta and North Georgia, I should say, also into eastern portions of Tennessee earlier today. That has since moved on. And over the Northeast, they're getting some lake effect snows now, but they had some pretty heavy snow showers earlier today over the Northeast, so things are quieting down there. But for us, it's cloudy. It's 66 degrees, and the dew point way up there, 62. Winds out of the east at 10. The pressure is at 30.09 inches. That's on the rise, and that's still high pressure. 1 degree above average today. That's the first in a while. And this morning's low also running above average. I should say 1 degree above average for the low. Now, rainfall so far for this month, we're just over a half inch. Temperatures currently up and down the coast into the mid-60s to low 70s down south into Key West, 71 there in Key West, and 71 in Miami. The Gulf water temperature 59, and temperatures all into the mid to upper 60s from Sebring to Lake Placid to Wauchula and Bradenton. The temperatures are going to stay warm throughout the rest of this week, at least through Friday, and then things are going to cool down. We have another cold front on the way. Notice I said cool down, not cold. It's going to be cooler than average, but nothing like the extreme temperatures that we saw last week. And the forecast tomorrow calls for a mixture of sun and clouds throughout the day. Once in a while, the sun will pop through and we'll warm up. Mid to upper 70s expected near the coast. Even some upper 70s to, I wouldn't be surprised, some low 80s into Highlands County and into Hardy and DeSoto counties as well. Well, here's the future cast showing that band of showers moving onshore throughout the early morning hours. And then that kind of lessening up somewhat with just a few spotty showers anticipated throughout the midday and into the afternoon. That rain will start to slowly taper off, so we're not expecting a widespread rainfall event with most of the activity staying offshore. Well, pretty quiet weather over the central plain states right now. Temperatures are much milder across the Great Lakes and throughout the Northeast in the 30s there. And the long-range trend is calling for that big Arctic spill again to move south and east, but should stay far enough to our north that it shouldn't be a real big factor, but we will cool down, as I mentioned, for the weekend. For boaters, east winds at 10 knots, a light chop out there in the bays and inland waters. The water temperature is now, as I said, into the upper 50s. Tides upcoming, high tide will be at 6:44 and sunrise at 7:21. Mostly cloudy, showers scattered about near the coast. The rain chance lessens as you push inland. And then tomorrow, look for, again, that's the wrong graphic. Computer's having a little issue right there, but we'll see a high of 75 tomorrow, 75 on Wednesday, and 76, look at that, warm on Thursday and Friday. And then it cools down, 68 on Saturday, 62 on Sunday, with low temperatures cooling down as well on Sunday and Monday, but not bad.